My name is Michael Burney, and I'll be going over modules in ServiceNow. In ServiceNow, menu headers are the applications and the children are the modules. For instance, problem is the application menu and open is the module. I'll showcase creating a brand new module. In order to do so, I'm going to need to be logged in as an administrator, and I'm going to need access to the application menus. So let's imagine this. Let's imagine that I work at an organization that would like to see all VIP users that have reported an incident. So in order to get this accomplished, I'll navigate to application menus. I'll search for incident. And I'll go ahead and select it. This is the application menu for incident in my left pane navigation. And once we go into the incident application menu, you can notice that you can see all the settings for this application menu. Like right now we can see for roles, it's restricted to ITIL and SN incident read. I'll scroll down even further. And here we get further options such as category, hint, and description. Beneath here, we see the modules and the modules settings as well. We want to create a new one, so I'll go ahead and select new. And be brought to this page. To fulfill our requirement, I'll go ahead and specify a title. I'll call this Open VIP, and I'll place it at order 310. I'll leave hint blank, and think of hint as hover text, and I'll check underneath the visibility tab. Here we have roles, active, and override application menu roles. Roles will leave blank because our parent already has roles and those cascade down to this module. If I ever wanted to override that, I would select this and then input the roles that I would like to keep rolling with. Link type. Underneath the link type tab, this is where we'll specify the contents of the module and what it brings up whenever the user clicks it. So for this, I'll go ahead and select table and I'm working with incident. There's no view associated with this that I need to use. I would like to see everything active. For VIP users. Arguments, I'll leave blank. Think of arguments as a custom filter for things like sorting. And for window name, I'll leave that blank as well. And because I leave it blank, whenever a user clicks the module, it'll open up in the current window pane. If I were to add text here, such as underscore blank, this would open up the contents in a new tab. I'll go ahead and submit. Scroll down. And here we can see the new module that we created. I'll click into it further. And since we submitted that, we can now go to the new classic mobile modules. And I'll go ahead and select it. This takes us to the creation of a ServiceNow classic mobile applications module. So I'll add an order for showcasing purposes. And we can see our application menu, table, and filter have all come over from the previous module that was just created. And beneath here, we can see path and path relative to root. Just for showcasing purposes, I'll fill this in. So let's imagine path relative to root was checked. If path relative to root is checked, that means that this module will open up in the desktop platform view. But left unchecked, it'll open up in the mobile view. I'll leave it unchecked. Now I'll exit out of this. And we can go see the module that we created. To do so, I'll refresh the browser. And I'll navigate to incident. And the incident application menu has the Open VIP module we just created. I'll walk into it. And here we can see all VIP users who have opened incidents. And that's my showcase of modules in ServiceNow. Thank you, and be sure to like and subscribe.